Good morning, everyone. Welcome to worship this Sunday before Thanksgiving. We're going to do something a little bit different today by celebrating what's called a love feast. A love feast, if you're not familiar, is a way to worship together and celebrate a meal, kind of like communion, but in a less official way. John Wesley, who is the guy who started the United Methodist Church, he encountered a love feast when he was traveling in Germany, and he met with a group of people called the Moravians, and they were a religious group of people, and they would celebrate these things called love feasts. And during a love feast, they would gather together, they would sing songs about God, they would tell stories about the way that God was with them in their life, and they would pray together. And so we're going to do that together. It sounds a lot like what we normally do for church, but it happens in a less formal way. Sitting together around a table or just on your couches in your living room or maybe in your room if you're still in isolation. And we're going to celebrate a meal together, kind of like what we're going to do for Thanksgiving this coming Thursday. During this service, you're going to have a snack that we've dropped off to your cottage. It's going to be some form of bread and some type of juice. And we'll let you know when, but you'll get to enjoy this meal together and share in some questions. But before we get to that point, we're going to start off this time of worship with a song as a way to prepare our hearts for sharing together.
Good morning, worshipers. Proud of you guys, how you've been worshiping with us the last few weeks. I know it's been different and difficult. But I'm proud of the way that you guys have been connecting with each other and with God. And with this week being a love feast, I wanted us to focus on loving each other, but also God's love for us. I know it's not always easy. I know it's always difficult, actually, to love well. And so this morning, God, I pray that we would just be able to connect to your heart for us, connect to your heart for others, that we would learn to love well, even in the midst of disconnection, God. We thank you for your presence, for your love, Jesus.
You found me, God.
was your fault. Still your love fought for me. Yeah. You have been so, so good to me. So good, so good. When I felt no worth, you paid it all for me. Oh, you have been so, so kind to me. And oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, fights till I'm found, leaves the 99. And I couldn't earn it, and I don't deserve it. Still, you give yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God.
And you won't climb up, coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me, God. There's no
no shadow you won't light.
There's nothing that could ever separate me. Oh, there's nothing. Oh, there's nothing that could ever separate me from your love. No height, no depth, no valley too deep for your love to find me, God. No height, no depth, no valley too deep for your love to find me, oh God. There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. No shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me, oh. No wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me, oh. The overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down. If I still I'm found, it leaves the 99. And I couldn't earn it, I don't deserve it. So you give yourself away. Oh, you overwhelm me, never ending.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity to gather together in fellowship. May we be reminded each and every day of the many blessings in our lives. Continue to be with us in mind, body, and soul. We pray all this in your Son's name. Amen. Join us in our scripture reading, which we'll find in 1 John chapter 4, verses 7 through 21. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is from God. Everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, for God is love. God's love was revealed among us in this way. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him. And this is love. Not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the atoning sacrifice for our sins. Beloved, since God loved us so much, we also ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God. If we love one another, God lives in us, and his love is perfected in us. By this, we know that we abide in him and he in us, because he has given us his Spirit. And we have seen and do testify that the Father has sent his Son as the Savior of the world. God abides in those who confess that Jesus is the Son of God, and they abide in God. So we have known and believe that the love of God is for us. God is love. And those who abide in love abide in God, and God abides in them. Love has been perfected among us in this, that we may have boldness on the day of judgment, because as he is, so are we in this world. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear, for fear has to do with punishment, and whoever fears has not reached perfection in love. We love because he first loved us. Those who say, I love God, and hate their brothers or sisters are liars. For those who do not love a brother or sister whom they have seen cannot love God whom they have not seen. The commandment we have from him is this: those who love God must love their brothers and sisters also. This is the word of God for the people of God.
And now we're going to enter into the discussion portion of our worship time together. In the history of a love feast, this is when they would share testimonies, which means that they would share stories about how God's been working in their life. We've provided you with a few discussion questions to ask each other during this time. But before we get there, Miss Betty and I are going to give you our answers to these questions because that sounds like fun. Yeah!
Our first question is, what is your favorite part of the Thanksgiving meal?
My favorite part is the stuffing. I look forward to it every year. This is the time of year that I start getting really excited about stuffing. When else do you get to eat that? So what's your favorite?
It's definitely the dessert. Mm. I am one to eat the pie before I eat the meal. I enjoy the sweets and the pumpkin pies and the pecan pies during Thanksgiving.
Our second question is, what are you grateful for today?
I am grateful for the people in my life and the friendships and the friends that I have who have become like an extended family. So yeah, I would say the people in my life.
I would say today, especially, I'm grateful for Miss Betty and Mr. Blake. The past couple of weeks, just like in your life, they've been a little bit crazy, right? Like we're all kind of stuck in our cottages and things aren't looking like normal. And Miss Betty and Mr. Blake have been part of keeping things normal for me in my life. And also, we've just had a lot of fun making these videos for you all. So I hope that you've been enjoying them. There will be a blooper reel probably sometime in the future so that you guys can laugh along with us. But we've had a lot of fun, and so I'm grateful for the team that we have here to help bring worship to you. Our last question is, how have you experienced love recently? And this gets to our scripture passage where we talked about love and how God is love. And if we love God, then that means that we love people around us. So how have you experienced love recently?
Recently, a friend asked me, how are you doing? Which is a very typical question that, you know, we ask all the time when we see somebody. And, you know, you usually give that typical answer, oh, I'm good, or I'm fine. But this friend literally asked me, no, for real, how are you doing? And this friend allowed me to really express how I was doing and not just give like a vague answer, but sat down and allowed me to go into detail as to what are all the ups and the downs of what I've experienced recently or things I've been going through. And I felt like that truly felt like love for you to stop and deeply ask somebody how they're doing instead of just kind of staying on the surface.
I was trying to think about in my own life, this might sound silly, but I experienced love through my dog. She's really cute. When I come home, I look forward to coming home because she's always excited to see me. And the other day I was on the couch while my husband was having to do some different things for work and she came up and snuggled next to me and so helped me not feel alone. And I really appreciate that about having a pet. I've also will say, this isn't me personally, but I have seen God's love a lot here on campus lately with the way that our house parents have been caring for each of you and working and pulling together as a team to make sure that we overcome the coronavirus together. And so I'm really grateful for the ways that our house parents are sharing God's love each and every day with all of you all over all of our different campuses. So at this time, you should have received a snack. So Miss Betty and I have some pumpkin bread and our apple cider. And you can share this snack with one another. This is the part of the meal, the feast part of the love feast. It's kind of like communion, but not, but it's an opportunity for us to share a meal together and some time together. And then I want you to spend time answering these same discussion questions that Miss Betty and I just discussed. And pause the video at this point and unpause it once you've finished your conversation. Welcome back. I hope that you all enjoyed your time of discussion together and your snack. At this time, we're going to join in prayer together. If you would like to take a minute to share some prayer requests that you have with the people that you're gathered with right now, you can do that. A few of you sent us prayer requests that we're going to lift up right now. We have a couple from Waller Jeter specifically about their program and praying that they can get through their program in a timely manner and transition to the next level of care. We also have gotten some prayer requests for everybody's health as we all continue to work to overcome the coronavirus. So we want to make sure that everyone heals and for our staff who are helping to take care of you all. So we're going to go ahead and say a prayer together. Let us pray. God, we give you thanks for this season of gratitude. And in a time where we might feel anything but thankful, God, I pray that your spirit might move within us to help us have eyes to see the way that you are at work in this time. God, I pray that you would move in our hearts so that we could take on an attitude of gratitude for those things that you have blessed us with. Even if it's something small, God, I pray that you would reveal those things to us so that we can give you thanks and can share in this positive attitude together. We pray for all of our kids all across our campus. We pray for those in Waller-Jeter who lifted up specific prayer requests for the next steps for them. God, we lift up all of our kids as we continue to heal and all, from all the various ways that we've been sick or might have been sick or been in contact with people who've been sick. God, we pray that you would pour out your Holy Spirit to provide healing for all of us. We ask that you be with our staff as they continue to provide care, that you would strengthen them and help them to have the endurance and perseverance to keep going. God, we give you thanks for the ways that you are present with us when we gather together, whether it's at a table for dinner or in a church for worship. We know that you are present with us everywhere that we go. Help us to feel your presence this week. We ask this in the name of Jesus. Amen.
A thousand generations, your family.
inside you, all around you, and within you. Forsaken us, you've never abandoned us.
And every evening you are there with us, pouring out over us, watching over us in every place that we go, every step that we take, God. You have not forgotten us for one moment. We were too valuable to you for you to let us go. Not only are you with us in every step that we take, but God, you are for us. You're not angry with us. You're not upset with us. You love us just as we come to you, God. So today I pray that we would live in that truth. That you love your children more than we could ever know and understand, God. And you shower us with gifts of kindness and love and provision in every place that we go, God. So I thank you for all that you are and all that you've done for us.
For our benediction today, we're going to read a blessing from Jan Richardson, and it talks about God's table. So let's hear this blessing as we prepare to leave today. And the table will be wide, and the welcome will be wide, and the arms will open wide to gather us in, and our hearts will open wide to receive, and we will come as children who trust that there is enough, and we will come unhindered and free. And our aching will be met with bread, and our sorrow will be met with wine. And we will open our hands to the feast without shame. And we will turn towards each other without fear. And we will give up our appetite for despair. And we will taste and know of delight. And we will become bread for a hungering world. And we will become drink for those who thirst. And the blessed will become the blessing. And everywhere there will be a feast. Have a wonderful week, friends, and I hope that you go from this place and this time and that you share God's love with the people around you. Bye.